But wish you were closer to. Remember that he can be near to you while you're dancing. Though you've only just said hello, he's suddenly someone who can make all your daydreams appear to you while you're dancing. Let the music weave a spell, whirl away your worries. Things look almost twice as well when they're slightly blurry.
As around and around you go, your spirits will hit the top. And now that we're dancing, who cares if the year is gone? And now that we're dancing, who cares if the year is
fine. My daughter Fanny got married, you know.
Did she?
A year ago last September. It's been a long time since you lived here, Mrs. Levi. Such a long, long time.
Ephraim, let me go. It's been long enough, Ephraim. Every night for all these years, I've put out the cat, I've locked the door, I've made myself a little rum toddy. And before I went to bed, I said a prayer thanking God that I was independent and that no one else's life was mixed up with mine. And then one night, an oak leaf fell out of my Bible. I placed it there when you asked me to marry you, Ephraim. It was a perfectly good oak leaf, but without color and without life. And I suddenly realized that I was like that leaf. For years, I had not shed one tear, nor had I been filled with that wonderful hope that something or other would turn out well. And so I've decided to rejoin the human race. And Ephraim, I want you to give me away. Before the parade passes by, I'm gonna get in step while there's still time left. Before the parade passes by.
Mrs. Levi, come along. Cornelius is taking us to see the 14th Street Parade. Everyone will be marching.
Why, Irene, you're crying.
Oh, Dolly, the world is full of wonderful things. Come with us, Dolly.
I will, Irene. I will.
Before the parade passes by, I'm gonna go taste Saturday's high life. Before the parade passes by, I'm gonna get some life back into my life. I'm ready to move out in front. I've had enough of just passing by life. With the rest of them, with the best of them, I can hold my head. Before the parade passes by,
Mrs. Levi! Mrs. Levi! She's beautiful. Everything you said and more. Hey, don't move, Miss Money. I'm coming. I'm on my way. Hey, you fellas, cut that out. That's my fiance. Stop these. Put that back. I paid for that girl, and I want all the parts. Hey, what are you doing, Miss Money? What have they done to you? Mrs. Levi, what is the meaning of this?
Oh, nothing to get upset about, Horace. A last-minute substitution. Miss Money had a sudden urgent business appointment at the Mint. They ran a little short, and she's helping out. But she'll meet you tonight at the Harmonia Gardens restaurant at 8 o'clock.
That's the most expensive restaurant in the city.
And well, it should be. What food and the fastest waiters in New York. Oh, by the way, I might be a few minutes late, so Miss Money will meet you in front of the restaurant. Oh, wait till you see her, Horace, all in buttercup yellow with baby pink shoes, singing an old-fashioned tune, Sweet Rosie O'Grady. Oh, you couldn't miss her if you tried.
I'll be there, Dolly. But only because I already paid for the introduction and I might as well get my money's worth. But from this point on, you are hereby discharged as my marriage broker. Is that clear? From now on, Dolly Gallagher, you're just a woman like anyone else. Hey, what's happening? Where are you taking me? Hey, well, at least let me off at Lexington and 46th Streets, will you?
Ephraim, he's as good as mine. I'm gonna raise the roof, I'm gonna carry on. Give me an old trombone, give me an old baton. Before the parade passes by.
Thank you.
just love looking at the lights at 14th Street these past 4 hours. But now perhaps you'd better call a hack or we won't get to the Harmonia Gardens on time. Oh, there's one!
We couldn't do that. It's not the money or anything. It's just that nowadays, really elegant people never take hacks.
Hacks is out.
They all go by streetcar.
J.P. Vanderbilt, Diamond Jim Morgan.
Well, then by all means, a streetcar.
Imagine! Just think! I've been elegant all my life and never even knew it!
Of course, if you really want to be elegant...
We do!
You walk.
Yes, New York, it's really us, Barnaby and Cornelius.
All the guests of Mr. Happel are feeling great and look spectacular.
What a mess there is to them, acting like a poor aristocrat. We got elegance. If you ain't got elegance, you can never ever carry it on.
All who are well-bred agree, Minnie Fay has pedigree.
Exercise your wildest whims tonight. We are out with diamond gems tonight.
Could they be misleading us?
Silver spoons were used for feeding us. We got elegance. If you ain't got elegance, you can never ever carry it on. Middle class, don't speak of it, savoir faire. We reek of it, some were born with rags and patches, but we use dollar bills for matches and
Vanderbilt kowtows to us.
J.P. Morgan scrapes and bows to us.
We got elegance, we were born with elegance.
Have you noticed when I hold my cup, the saucer never moves?
And the way I keep my pinky up indubitably proves that
we got elegance. We got built in elegance and with elegance.
Oh, look, Minnie, they're counting their money again. Isn't that just like the rich? Well, gentlemen, aren't you going to escort us in?
Oh, of course, Mrs. Malloy. Oh, Barnaby. Mrs. Malloy.
Yes, Mr. Hackle.
I was wondering, as we go inside, may I...
Yes, Mr. Hackle?
May I put my arm around your waist?
Yes, Mr. Hackle. But I might as well warn you, a corset is a corset.
Show your uncle we mean business. Now can't you weep a little faster? You're throwing me off step. Faster. And one, two, three. And one, two, three. That's it.
Philharmonia Gardens und your supreme commander that tonight of all nights our usual lightning service will be twice as lightning as ever, or else. Satisfactory, sir. The private dining rooms cost a bit more, but they do offer the best view of the entertainment.
$1.40, Cornelius. That's all that's left.
Are you sure? Count it again.
Prepare yourself for a big night, Minnie. We're out with two of New York's best-known sports.
Cornelius, I did make a mistake. It's $1.45. I'll count it again.
No, don't. We can't afford it.
I'm going to order everything on the menu. Waiter!
And who do you think I am? Only it's Horace Vandergelder und party. She's in my und party, and I ain't in hers.
Mr. Vandergelder, of course. It's just that Mrs. Levi mentioned nothing about you bringing your...
My personal physician. That's enough rouge, doctor.
But Mrs. Levi only ordered a chicken for two.
Chickens are dear.
Und was a soul soup. Souffle.
When you tell me this was an Oriental establishment, we'll take two bowls of rice. Now get out. Now, Miss Money, I understand you carry respectable sums in your belt.
Yeah, $2. Only it's in my garter.
Reputations, Cornelius, but Minnie and I don't care who sees us tonight. Well, have you decided, Minnie?
Oh, I couldn't have anything at these prices, really. I couldn't.
Oh, great grindstones. What a sensible girl. Our waiter, bring us 4 glasses of beer, a loaf of yesterday's bread, and some cheese.
Yesterday's bread. Oh, Cornelius, now I know how you keep half of New York in stitches all the time. Minnie, have you ever eaten pheasant?
Pheasant!
It's not that. I felt a slight chill.
Oh, well, why didn't you say so? Here, I'll loan you this. Now, let's order something to hold us till the rice comes. Waiter, would you bring a roast suckling pig with chestnut and oyster stuffing, cheese fondue, and some lady fingers? What do you have?
Oh,
should do one after the show.
It's sweet of you to worry about our digestion, Cornelius, but I'm sure the pheasants are fresh. We'll take four, please, and a nice red wine.
Oh, wait a minute. No wine.
No wine?
Champagne.
Champagne.
Oh, it's once in a lifetime, Barnaby. Champagne and Neapolitan ice cream and hothouse peaches. And Barnaby, give the band leader a nickel and tell him to play To a Wild Rose. We want music while we dine.
Say, this is a cafe, isn't it? Well, let's dance.
The Vandergelders do not dance, Miss Money. We're Presbyterian.
All right, I'll dance myself. Here, give $2 for the band leader, will you? And tell him to play something refined. I'm gonna do the hoochie coochie.
Oh.
Cornelius, I'll send for the band, but promise you won't order anything else.
You wait here, Miss Money. I'll get them to play a nice waltz. Give this to the band leader and tell him to play a waltz.
Here's a nickel. Have the band leader play To a Wild
Miss Rose. Money!
And two more pheasants, please.
Cornelia!
Oh, my purse.
My wallet.
Oh, here you. That's my purse. Miss Money, get off that table. You're dancing in the stew.
Excuse me. That's my wallet. I know it's mine because there's nothing in it. But a dollar, three dimes, five pennies, and... Cornelius! Cornelius! Did he say two pheasants? Three, four pheasants for the house. And never mind if we don't see the whale. I'll buy one of my own.
What's this shouting? How many times have I told you not to shout, boy? This is the Harmonia Gardens restaurant, not for the zoo.
Yes, I know, Kermit. She's here, the lady.
What? Are you sure, boy?
Yes, sir. Just like you told me. 8 o'clock on the nose, up pulls a carriage, out steps a beautiful tall brunette, and the biggest handbag I ever saw.
It's she, Mrs. Levi. She's back.
Really, it's true. I heard the sound of laughter outside the kitchen window. Could it be?
It is. It's Dolly. Fritz. Tell the man. She just stepped out of a carriage.
Rudy, is it true? Is it true?
It's true, yeah. She just stepped out of a white gold carriage pulled by six black horses with scarlet plumes. Ha 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 ha.
Rudy, beats my gold pants again.
Thank you.
nice to be back home where I belong. You're looking swell, Manny. I can tell, Danny. You're still glowing, you're still growing, you're still going strong. I feel the room swaying for the band's playing one of my old favorite songs from way back when. So bridge that gap, fellas, find me an empty lap, fellas, Dolly will never go.
Yeah.
Oh, excuse me, girlie. Dolly Gallagher, what are you doing in that getup? And you're half an hour late, and I demand an explanation of...
Ernestina.
Exactly.
Ernestina, whom I trusted.
She wanted to do the hoochie-coochie.
Well, she always was artistic. Now, Horace, I am going to have our table moved right down front. There's someone in the dance competition I particular want you to see. Now, don't let's say another word about it. I am as shocked as you are. I couldn't eat a thing. What have you ordered?
Just what you wanted, a chicken. Now, see here, Dolly, about that hoochie-coochie girl.
Did you say a chicken? Oh, I don't think I could face a chicken. Not a chicken. Not today. Not after what's happened.
Good. Cancel the chicken.
And bring a turkey.
What are you doing now?
Shh. Nothing. Just looking around. Getting acquainted with the surroundings.
That's the trouble with you, Dolly. Always have to know everything. Always put your nose in everyone else's affairs. Anybody who'd marry you get as nervous as a cat.
What? What's that you're saying?
I said anybody who'd marry you get as
nervous as a... Horace Vandegelder, you get that idea right out of your head this minute. Why, I am shocked that you even mentioned such a thing. Understand once and for all that I have no intention of marrying you.
I didn't mean that.
Well, I certainly do hope not. Horace Vandegelder, you go your way and I'll go mine. I am not some Irene Malloy whose head can be turned by a few chocolate-covered peanuts, unshelled. Why, the idea of you even suggesting such a thing.
Mrs. Levi, you have misunderstood me.
Well, I certainly do hope not. But if I had any intention of marrying again, it would be to a far more pleasure-loving man than you. However, we won't discuss the matter anymore. Here's the waiter with our food. I'll serve Mr. Vandegelder Rudolph. Well, here's some white meat for you, and some dumplings, lighter than air they are, and some giblets, very tender, very good for you. No, Horace, as I said before, you go your way, and I'll go mine. Now, you start right in on the wine. I'm sure you'll feel better at once. However, since you brought the matter up, there's one more thing I think I ought to say.
I didn't bring the matter up at all.
One more thing I ought to say before we forget all about it. It's true. I am a woman who likes to know everything that's going on, who likes to manage things. But I wouldn't want to manage anything as out of control as your household. No, you'll have to do that yourself, God helping you. Cheers.
It's not out of control.
Very well, let's not say another word about it. Here, Horace, have some beets. They're good.
I don't like beets.
That's good. No, Horace, a complaining, quarrelsome, friendless soul like you is no sort of companion for me. You salt your beets. And I'll salt mine.
Will you stop saying that?
I won't say another word.
Good.
Except this. At your age, Horace, you should enjoy hearing the honest truth.
My age. You're always talking about my age.
Well, I don't know what your age is, but I do know that up in Yonkers, with bad food and bad temper, you'll double it in 6 months. Here, Horace, have some more beets.
They're good. I don't like beets. I hate beets.
That's good. Now, you just dig right in. Yes, the pity of it is, Horace, you could be a perfectly charming, witty, amiable man if you wanted to.
I don't want to be charming!
But you are. Just look at you now. You can't hide it. Now, sit down, Horace, and let's talk of something else. But before we change the subject, there is one more thing I am going to say.
I don't want to hear it, and you're wasting your time, Dolly Levi. I won't ask you to marry me.
Well, I suppose that means you want me to ask you. Well, I am sorry, Horace. I am turning you down.
How can you turn me down when I haven't asked you anything?
It's no use arguing. I've made up your mind. Here, let me cut your wings.
I've got a headache. I'm going back to my hotel.
Oh, no, now you can't go. Now the competition's about to begin.
Here's some money for the dinner. Here's $20. Wait a minute. There's nothing here but a dollar, three dimes, five pennies, and a button that's in my purse. I've lost my purse!
Barnaby, that purse you found.
Impossible. I can't imagine you without your purse.
$50. Cornelius, we gotta get out of here.
What am I gonna do? I haven't been here before. They don't know me. Stop eating that turkey. I can't pay for it.
Oh, Horace, look. It's the latest thing, a polka. And there is one dancer in particular I want you to see. Rudolph, would you move our table right down front so Mr. Van de Gelder can better observe his graceful movements?
Wait. That man! That dancer!
Isn't he wonderful? With talent like that, he's sure to win the solid gold cup.
Come along, Mrs. Malloy. It's been a lovely evening, but I'm afraid we'll have to cut it a bit short.
Oh, Minnie, a polka! Cornelius, I simply must have one dance.
But Van de Gelder's right there. We gotta go.
We will go, but we'll dance our way out.
Tackle!
Oh, Mr. Van de Gelder!
Oh! Barnaby Tucker!
Mr. Van de Gelder!
Irvin God! Dolly Levi, this is your doing. What are you up to?
Oh, Mr. Van de Gelder, I can explain.
I don't want to hear any explanations. You're fired!
Violations of the law of this city. Is there anyone here to speak in your behalf? Is there anyone here to speak in your behalf? This is Dolly Levi, counselor at law.
Your Honor, the defense rests.
No,
there is no need to call witnesses, ladies and gentlemen, when I see on that bench a brow that gleams with honor, masculine whiskers that bristle with fair play, and a nose. I ask you to look at that nose, ladies and gentlemen, a nose that shines in the night like a flaming beacon of justice. Your Honor, would you turn this way a bit so we can get a better look at your beacon? Oh, a living symbol of the motto of this great land, E Probuscus Unum. Your Honor, I ask for freedom for my clients and a verdict of guilty for the only real culprit, Horace Vandegelder of Yonkers, New York.
Dolly!
The one man responsible for these grievous charges of willful destruction of private property.
A curtain tore, a Vita bruised, and a solid gold cup bent.
Cruelty to a poor, unfortunate minor. Would you mind repeating that, dear?
Oh, begging your pardon, Mrs. Levi, but if it please the court, I have something to say.
Well, I was just about to call on you, Mr. Hackle. Go right ahead.
Cornelius Hackle, if you dare testify against me, I'll have you discharged.
Oh, you've done that already, Mr. Vandergelder.
I'll do it again.
You've done it again, too. But even if you hadn't, I'd still say what I have to say. Your Honor, I don't know much about disturbing the peace or inciting to riot, but I do know that what happened to me today, which is the most important thing that can happen to a man, might never have happened if I'd stayed in Yonkers, New York, and obeyed your orders. Your Honor, I'm talking about none other than love.
What? You trying to tell me that after 33 years, you fall in love because you take one evening off?
Oh, no, Mr. Vandergelder. I didn't fall in love with Mrs. Irene Malloy of this city in just an evening. An hour. Even that's too long. What's less than a minute?
A second?
Oh, less than that.
Moment.
Oh, that's it. I'll go slowly, so you can get it all down.
It only takes a moment for your eyes to meet, and then your heart knows in a moment you will never be alone again. I held her for an instant, but my arms felt sure and strong. It only takes a moment loved a whole life long.
Isn't the world full of wonderful things? There I sat cooped up in Yonkers for years and years, and all the time wonderful people like Mrs. Malloy were walking around in New York, and I didn't know them at all. Oh, I don't know if you can all see from where you're sitting, but, well, for instance, the way her cheek and her forehead and her eye all come together right here. I tell you right now, a fine woman is the greatest work of God on earth. Oh, you can talk about the pyramids and Niagara Falls, but they're not in it at all. Of course, I've seen women before, but today I talked to one equal to equal. And they're so different than men. And they're awfully mysterious too. Why, I bet you could know a woman 100 years and never really be sure whether she liked you or not. Today I've lost so many things. My job, my future, everything that people think is important. But I don't care. Even if I have to dig ditches the rest of my life, I'll be a ditch digger that once had a wonderful day.
Few words back there, Mr. Hackle. Right after it only
takes a moment. Oh.
but his arms felt safe and strong.
That is all that love's about,
and we'll recall till time runs out.
That it only took a moment to be
Vandergelder of Yonkers, New York. You're all dismissed. You're free, my children. And bless you. Go. Go.
Mrs. Levi, you can see the prisoner now.
Well, Horace, there's your life. Without niece, without clerks, without bride, and without your purse. Looks like there's only one more thing to say.
If it's to ask me to marry you, Dolly Levi, never. Not in a million years. Under no circumstances will I marry you.
Oh, that wasn't it at all, Horace. All I wanted to say to you was... goodbye!
What?
Goodbye!
Hold on, Dolly.
No, Horace, it's too late. I have failed. And when a woman fails, there is nothing more she can say.
Wait!
But...
hey!
Goodbye! Goodbye! Goodbye, 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 goodbye. Don't try and stop me, Horace.
That's a $6
damage. Wave your little hand and whisper so long, dearie. You ain't gonna see me anymore. But when you discover that your life is dreary, don't you come a-knocking on my door. For I'll be all dolled up and singing that song that says you don't.
Yeah.
I told you so. So wave your little hand and whisper so long, dearie. Dearie should have said so long ago. Because you've treated me so rotten and rough, I've had enough. Whisper so long, dearie. Dearie should have said so long, so long ago. For I can hear that choo-choo calling me on to a fancy new address. Yes, I can hear that choo-choo calling me on board that happiness express. I'm gonna learn to dance and drink and smoke a cigarette. I'm going as far away from Yonkers as a goo can get. And on those cold winter nights, Horace, you can snuggle up to your cash register. little lumpy, but it rings. Don't come a-knocking, I'll be all dolled up and singing that song that I told you so. So, Horace, you will find your life a sad old story when you see a dolly shuffle off to glory. Oh, I should have said so
the last woman on earth. Not if you ask me a million times. I didn't need you before, and I don't need you now. You go your way, and I'll go mine. Dolly. Polly, Dolly, Dolly.
You stamped, what? Mr. Vandergelder.
Oh. So it's you, is it, Mr. Hackle? Come calling back, have you?
Oh, no, sir. I've just come by for my $146.35. You see, I've decided to go into business for myself. And since the only business I know is hay and feed, I'm opening my own store.
Wait. And Cornelius has found the perfect location, Mr. Vandergelder. Right across the street from you.
So you think you could compete with Vandergelders, do you? Well, you just try. What? Oh, another one come crawling, is it? What do you want?
My back salary for the past 4 months, $6.12.
You can't do this to me, any of you. I'll go to the courts. I'll get lawyers.
Why, Horace Vandergelder, as I live and breathe, if you aren't handsome in that outfit. So few men these days have the courage to wear those colors.
Dolly Gallagher!
I know what you're going to say, Horace. You're not satisfied with Ernestina. Well, I have another girl for you, the ideal wife, but don't let me interrupt. You were doing something, weren't you? What were you doing?
Getting Cornelius's money, Dolly. $146.
And 35 cents.
And $6.12 of mine.
And the money my mama left me.
$52.48.
38!
48. 48!
All right. All right. If it's the money you want, the safe is back here.
$52.
Money, 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 money. Mr. Vandergelder's money. It's like the sun we walk under. It can kill or cure. Vandergelder is never tired of saying that most people in the world are fools. And in a way, he's right, isn't he? Himself, Irene, Cornelius, myself. Oh, yes, we're all fools. And we are in danger of destroying the world in our folly. But the surest way to keep us out of harm is to give us the 4 or 5 human pleasures that are our right in the world. And that takes a little money. Now, the difference between a little money and no money at all is enormous and can shatter the world. And the difference between a little money and an enormous amount of money is very slight. But that can shatter the world too. It's all in how you use it. My late husband, Ephraim Levi, used to say, money, pardon the expression, is like manure. It's not worth a thing unless it's spread around encouraging young things to grow. Anyhow, that is the opinion of the second Mrs. Vandergelder. Which reminds me, Ephraim, I'm ready for that sign.
Well, don't just stand there. That goes upstairs.
Well, Horace, as I said before, I have found you the ideal wife.
Dolly Levi, I don't want you to find me no ideal wives. If I want to find me an ideal wife, I'll find one of my own. And I found one. And it's you, damn it.
Why, Horace?
Oh, I know. I made a fool of myself over Mrs. Malloy and that other woman. But, Dolly, forgive me. And marry me?
Horace, Stop right there.
What do you mean?
Oh, Horace, you know as well as I do that you're the first citizen of Yonkers, that your wife would have to be somebody. Answer me. Am I a somebody?
You are. Wonderful woman.
Oh, well, you're partial. No, Horace, it wouldn't be enough to load your wife with money and jewels, to insist that she be a benefactress to half the town. And by the way, you know it's bad business letting Cornelius open a store right across the street from you. You better take him back and let him be your partner.
Partner?
And then Barnaby can have Cornelius's
now,
old job.
Hold on,
and
Dolly.
That way we'll all be together to dance at Ermengarde's wedding.
That doesn't. You've gone too far, Dolly. I'll dance at no weddings. Besides, I don't know how to dance. It'd take me weeks, months, years. All right, I'll dance.
Horace Vandegelder, I never thought I'd hear you say a thing like that.
Sir!
That front room, idiot! What are you waiting for?
Horace Vandegelder, what is going on up there?
Oh, nothing. I just thought I'd have this entire building done over in blue wallpaper.
Horace!
I know, the old wallpaper ain't wore out yet. But you see, that fella's just set up in business, and he needs a good start. You see, Dolly, I've always felt that money, you should pardon the expression, is a lot like manure. It ain't worth it.
Thank you, Ephraim.
Hello, Dolly. Well, hello, Dolly. It's so nice to have you here where you belong. I never knew, Dolly, without you, Dolly, life was awfully flat. More than that was awfully wrong.
Here's my hat, Horace. I'm staying where I'm at, Horace. Dolly will never go away.
Wonderful woman.